Well, I think it's apparent, Vint, in this interview alone of how extraordinary of an out-of-the-box thinker you really are. And technical skills are important, but what does it really take to become a revolutionary thinker?
I don't necessarily consider myself to be a revolutionary thinker. Remember, my view of the internet is that it was an engineering problem. The discovery that it could be used for all of these other things is, sort of an incremental discovery as opposed to something, blossoming like the birth of Venus. But I will say that revolutionary thinking does require you to discard old ideas and a willingness to set aside the beliefs of the past and accept the possibility that something that sounds crazy might actually hold weight or hold water, I guess. And a lot of science, especially if you talk to Nobel Prize winners, for example, a lot of them will tell you that their colleagues rejected their ideas and said that, that's just wrong. We know better. You're crazy. You're making it up, or your data is flawed. Maybe you need glasses. I mean, there's a whole series of stories like that, and the persistence of those scientists is what counts. So patience and persistence are two key elements of success in innovation.